ஓகே நீங்கள் எடுக்கிறீங்க எடுக்கணும் ஓகே
அந்த
different surfactants that are used
First, we make an immersion of water and hexane, then we make it the immersion, then we mill it with the zirconium balls, and then we add a surfactant, different surfactants, and then we mill it once again, and we will dry it in the presence of sun. Then we gasing it for 400 degrees Celsius in molten furnace. Then we get a nanosilica that is grinded and capitalized in several particles, several analysis and instrumentation, like particle size and stream of serum type. Then, this is the PGA of the color body of the different surfactant. This is all decomposition are same. So we get up to 500 degrees, this is very stable one. So, coming to the particle size analysis, you can see it is around 300 to 500 nanometers. So when we gone to 10 analysis of that, especially in C-tab, we got a crystalline particles, and we got a FCC, a base-centered cubic structure. From the X-ray, we can also confirm that one. Next, coming to the optical property, this is the absorbance we got between 200 to 300, actually 400. It is the absorbance mix of the different CMRs that we are monitoring based on surfactants, with the different surfactants. And we have also done the emission spectrum through photoluminescence, and it also very successful in that we're comparing the different surfactants. And coming to the next, this is the semiconductor property. It has band gap of 3.2%. It is a semiconductive material, so it can be used for every electronic devices, and it can be applied for any material as an electronic device, or we can make a material for electronic devices. This is the XPS, and XPS confirms that. At the 920 and 901 and 885 electron volt, it converts to the integration of CEM4 oxide. So we don't get CE2O3, we get only CE4O2. That is confirmed through XPS. So the C1 condition, this 287 electron confirms that there is a CO formation, and 290 electron volt confirms that there is an impurity. That's not a very important one, but some impurities are there that can be decomposed through gasification and other processes. This is the same analysis, and you can see that this is the CM carbon. Ceres carbon we have got from IRE. So it is very agglomerated. It will subtract and without surfactant, we have gasified. So it forms some cubic forms, and with surfactants were monitored, the particles were reduced to some amounts. So if you see the NAR reflectance, it is very gradually increasing. You can see that 2080 has a larger 2080 and this 1080 has a larger NAR reflectance. So it can be used for NAR applications. So non-ionic surfactants play a major role in NAR reflectance. So we are coated with different glass materials for controlling the for the optical property, and we also took the cell for that solid that we have prepared. So we then discussed the viscosity also very finely done. And if you see the linear reflections of this glass material, you can see that we get a tremendous increase in the SLS and the C-tab. So, SLS and C-tab has great property on glass materials, and so it has 48% of reflectance and 40% of reflectance in C-tab, and the other surfactants doesn't have some effect on glass. So, we can confirm that SLS and C-tab has more NA reflectance on glass substrates. Coming to antimicrobial property, you can see E. coli and Candida albicans has the highest antimicrobial property on that when we use Syria and that organism, so we can confirm that these are the compare this study between the surfactants and which is the epidermis ceta benensis. This one is 380 spinate and Syria salt. Syria salt that is we coated with the glass. Then we compare with the Syria salt and the different surfactants, so we get a good antimicrobial properties. So coming to the conclusion, we have successfully done cerium oxide with this different surfactants, and the particle size ranges from 350 to 700. That is very suitable for paint applications and coating applications, and UV shielding also has a great property, and photoluminescence also is photoluminescence also plays a major role in this, and by quick function we can confirm that it can also act as a semiconductor material because of its electron volt value of around 3.25.
So
cerium oxide is a successful agent for NAR reflectance coatings, and especially CETA and sodium lauryl sulfate has the tendency to reflect NAR to and make it can produce as a paint combo, or it can be paint made for coating purposes on glass substrates, and we get around 20 to 30% of NAR reflectance in glass materials. So as far as we can concern, that cerium oxide is a very good compound to be used in several applications, especially in paint and coatings, and that this is the future of the globe, because it can protect the future through ozone depletion and reduce global warming. And you can say that every year 1 degree Celsius increasing, and the globe is increasing its temperature every 1 year. There is 1 degree of increase, okay? Then it's very important.
A gentle reminder, time is up.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for IIA for the funding, and VIT and ICANN organization. This is our mission.
I now open the floor to the questions from the audience.
Yeah, when it is coming around 100, below 100, you can call it as nanoparticle. saying nano cilia. It is a nanoparticle. Actually, we are trying to cerium oxide to convert into nanoparticle. We are trying for actually, we got only 300 to 500 that range. So, when we see in the TEM analysis, you can see there is a lot of change. This is a C-tab modified cerium oxide. So, we get a crystalline. So, it can confirm that there is some nanoparticles found below 100. We got 5 nanometers, this is here.
Without any further delay, I would like to call upon our third presenter.